Hi, CCSC. We're so glad you all are able to join us today. I want to start off by telling you these statements, and you can say if they're true or not. Are you ready? All right, here's the first one. It's impossible to hum while holding your nose. You can try that and see if it's true or not. The second one is, dogs can smell cancer. The next one is, bees can detect bombs. The next one is, when newborn babies cry, tears do not come out. How is that possible? The last one is, not everything you see on the news is true. Some of these statements sound pretty outrageous or crazy. Take this time to share with your family if you've ever heard a fact about something but wasn't sure if it was true. When have you doubted or questioned what someone said? I hope you had a fun discussion with your family. In today's Bible story, Jesus' disciples were told that Jesus was alive again. They thought that was completely outrageous. They had a hard time believing it because they saw Jesus nailed to the cross, they saw Jesus die, and they even placed him in a tomb. Listen carefully to today's Bible message to see how Jesus proved to his disciples that he is alive again.
Oh, God, my Father. Hi, Christ Central kids. Hi, Christ Central families. I'm going to lead in today's Bible reading. Today's passage is Luke chapter 24, verses 36 and 49, and John chapter 20, verse 24 and 29. Two passages. So let's go to Luke chapter 24. Get your Bibles and open up your Bibles to Luke chapter 24, big 2-4. Alright, and then we're going to look at verses 36 through 49. Luke chapter 24, verses 36 to 49. And we're going to do responsive reading, which means I'm going to read the odd verses and you're going to read the even verses out loud. And if you need help, make sure you ask your parents or a big brother or sister to help you read today's passage. Luke chapter 24, verses 36 to 49. Verse 36, while they were still talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." Verse 37, verse 38, he said to them, "Why do you trouble, and why do doubts rise in your minds?" When he had said this, he showed them his hands and feet. Verse 42, they give him a piece of broiled fish. He said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms." Verse 46, he told them, "This is what is written, the Messiah will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day." Verse 48, "You are witnesses of these things." And let's read verse 49 together. "I am going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." And then we're going to skip to John chapter 20, our second part of the passage. John chapter 20, we're going to flip a couple of pages. John big 20, big 20. And then we're going to read verse 24 and 29. John chapter 20, verse 24 to 29. And I'm going to ask you guys to read the even verses, and I'm going to read the odd verses. So you guys can start with verse 24. Ready, begin. Verse 25. "So the other disciples told them, 'We have seen the Lord.' But he said to them, 'Unless I see the nail marks in his hands and put my finger where the nails were and put my hand into his side, I will not believe.'" Verse 27. "Then he said to Thomas, 'Put your finger here. See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe.'" And let's read verse 29 together. 1, 2, 3. "Then Jesus told him, 'Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed.'" Amen. And this is God's word. All right, thank you for reading today's passages with me. I'll see you guys later, all right?
On the first day of the week, in the evening, the disciples gathered together in a house. They locked the doors because they were afraid of the Jews. They didn't want to be killed like Jesus had been killed. Some of Jesus' disciples had reported seeing him alive. Was it true? As the disciples talked, Jesus appeared among them and said, "Peace to you." The disciples were afraid. They thought they were seeing a ghost. "It's me," Jesus said. "Look at me and touch me. A ghost does not have flesh and bones, but I do." Jesus showed his disciples his hands and his side. They saw his wounds. The disciples rejoiced because they were so happy to see Jesus. The disciples gave Jesus some fish to eat. Jesus talked to them and explained the Bible to them. "The Bible is about me," Jesus said. He helped them understand how the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms told about him. Then Jesus told the disciples that they had a job to do. Jesus had died and was raised from the dead so that people could be forgiven for their sins. The disciples needed to tell other people to repent from their sins and be forgiven. Jesus said, "God sent me to earth, and in the same way, I am sending you." One of Jesus' disciples, Thomas, was not with the others when Jesus visited him. He did not believe that Jesus was alive. Thomas said, "I want to see and touch the holes in his hands and his side, or I will never believe." A week later, Thomas was with the disciples when Jesus appeared again. Jesus said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Reach out and touch my side. Don't be an unbeliever. Believe." Thomas did believe. "My Lord and my God," he said. Jesus said, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Those who believe in me without seeing me are blessed." For 40 days, Jesus presented himself to more than 500 people and proved that he is alive. Jesus is still alive today. We have not seen Jesus, but if we believe in him, we will be blessed. He sends out believers to tell others about him and gives us power through the Holy Spirit.
Last week, we learned about the two disciples that met Jesus on their way to Emmaus, but they didn't know it was him. When they finally realized that it was Jesus, he disappeared before their eyes. Those two disciples rushed back to Jerusalem to tell the other disciples what happened. And as the disciples talked about what the two disciples experienced, Jesus suddenly appeared before them. But all the disciples were afraid because they thought he was a ghost. Let's look in Luke chapter 24, verses 38 to 39 to see how Jesus responds. Verses 38 to 39 says, "He said to them, 'Why are you troubled? And why do doubts rise in your minds? Look at my hands and my feet. It is I myself. Touch me and see. A ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see I have.'" Jesus knew the hearts of the disciples. They were doubting that he was Jesus. Even after showing them his hands, feet, and sides, they still didn't believe. He then asked for something to eat, so he ate the fish that they gave him to prove that he is alive. Jesus then reminded them of what he told them when he was alive. Let's look at Luke chapter 24, verses 46 to 47. 46 to 47 says, "He told them, 'This is what is written. The Messiah will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem.'" It says that Jesus opened the minds of the disciples so that they could understand what was written, that Jesus was sent to suffer and to die and rise again after 3 days. And if we repent, Jesus will forgive our sins. The disciples were overjoyed when they realized and believed that it was Jesus. Now, Thomas, who is one of the 12 disciples, was not there when Jesus appeared before the others. The disciples excitedly told Thomas how they saw Jesus, but he doubted and he didn't believe. And he said, unless he sees Jesus' hands and sides, he would not believe. 1 week later, all the disciples, including Thomas, were at the same house and the doors were locked. And suddenly Jesus appeared before them again. Jesus told Thomas to touch his hands and the holes where the nails were. Thomas then believed. Jesus already knew that Thomas would only believe that he was alive again if he appeared before him and touched him. Let's turn to John chapter 20, verse 29. Verse 29 says, then Jesus told him, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. We can't see Jesus, but like what he said in this verse, if we believe in Jesus, we will be blessed. Boys and girls, did you know that Jesus sends out believers like us to tell others about him and gives us power through the Holy Spirit? I hope and pray that we all will have the courage to tell about Jesus wherever we go and whoever we meet. Let's pray. God, thank you so much for this reminder and the calling that you have for each and every one of us to tell and spread the gospel. God, we pray that you would help us in our faith in you, and that we would believe more and more whenever we read your word and spend time in prayer with you. Give us courage, God, to tell others about what you have done and what you continue to do. Thank you so much for forgiving us of our sins, Lord, that we would be thankful every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hi guys, I'm going to go over today's Bible memory verse. And the Bible memory verse is John chapter 11, verse 25. In the past few weeks, we've been breaking this up into two sections. The first section is, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. And last week, we learned the second portion, the one who believes in me will live even though they die. Now let's put that together. John chapter 11, verse 25. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. Now let's say it one more time. John chapter 11, verse 25. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. Very good. See, this passage is such a great reminder and such a great promise. It reminds us that if we truly believe in Jesus, and we truly believe Jesus is who he says he is, that we will have new life in him, that we will have eternal life in him. You see, sometimes it's so hard to believe without seeing with our own eyes. Just like Thomas. Thomas wanted to see Jesus. Thomas wanted to feel Jesus' side to see if he was real. But we must have faith. We must have faith and believe in our hearts. Jesus reminds us that we need to believe in him, that he is the resurrection, that he is the life. And if we do that, if we believe and have faith in Jesus, he will give us eternal life. This truth will change our lives forever. So boys and girls, I ask you that you memorize this verse, that you repeat this verse over and over again, and really believe that Jesus is the resurrection, that he is the life, and that we must believe in him. So today, to help you guys memorize this song, we're going to sing this verse, and we're going to dance to this verse, and we're going to have some fun, all right? Are you guys ready? All right, Jackson, hit the music.
Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is in the kingdom, in the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Hi, Christ Central families! For today's activity, you're gonna need some watercolor paints and paintbrush, a white piece of paper, a white crayon, and some water. We learned today that Jesus knew his followers needed more proof. So for 40 days, he presented himself and showed himself to over 500 people and proved that he is alive. Jesus is alive! Yay! We have not seen Jesus, but we believe by faith. He gives us power through the Holy Spirit. And let's think about that as we do our activity today. First, get your white paper and your white crayon and write a message like Jesus is alive, or Jesus loves you, or thank you, Jesus. You can even draw a cross. I'm gonna write, Jesus is alive. Here you go. Can you see the writing or the drawing? Nope, I cannot see it. White on white is difficult to see. It's hard to believe that it's even there, right? Now, get your paintbrush and your watercolor paints. And we're going to paint over our message or our drawing. Ready, guys? Whoa! Through the Holy Spirit and through God's good word, we know and we can believe by faith that Jesus is alive today. Wow, I can see my message! So cool! The message is coming out. Do you see my Jesus? Jesus is alive. Wow. I hope you guys have a fun time doing this activity and have a great week. Bye.